Have you spent a night overnight in jail?
Ever?
Yeah, a couple times.
Yeah. Wow, for what? No.
Always like fighting stuff, and then it was like an unpaid ticket. Fighting was usually I was out at the same time. But unpaid tickets, like you had to see a judge the next day kind of shit.
They lock you up for that?
Here in New York, yeah. I was driving. I didn't know I didn't have a license. I didn't know it was suspended because I didn't pay a ticket.
Wow.
They got me here in New York. That's the only time in New York I spent a night overnight.
They put you in General Pop?
Tombs, dude. Took me all over the place. Chain gang me to a dude who had a... It was crazy. They picked me up, or they got me. They pulled me over, and then they said they had to arrest me. Carla was pregnant with Isabella, and she was like, well, I'll just take over driving. I'm sorry, we didn't know that. It's not illegal to have a suspended license. It's illegal to drive on one.
Yeah.
So she's like, I'll just take over driving. I was like, yeah, officer, I'm sorry, I didn't know that it was thing. I'll take care of that, too, as soon as possible. It was like, nah, we already ran your thing, so we have to arrest you. So I kind of got that. I was like, I get it. I guess, you know, what are you going to do? And then they're like, you'll see a judge, you know, he'll tell you what you got to do, and you get out. And I'm like, yeah, okay. No problem. And I get out of the car, and then immediately, I thought we were all kind of being, like, nice to each other, the cops. Yeah. And then, like, I go, so what do I got? I go, can you, like, cuff me awake? My little brother was visiting.
Yeah.
Which made my parents super happy, because he was, like, 13 at the time.
Great.
They go, put your hands behind your back. I was like, you know, sure. And I put my hands behind my back. And then, like, immediately he grabbed my wrist and, like, put my face down on the car, like, hard.
And then Whipping Post started playing out of his car.
Yeah, no. Then they got mad that, like, he was having a hard time with the... Cause I have big wrists, so he was having a hard time with the cuffs. And he was getting pissed off, like, at me. And they brought over... Funny, like, an Asian cop came over and he was even saying, like... I think he even said, like, you know, like, hey, he's, like, he's not fighting, man. He's fine. Like, he was kind of cool.
Really?
But I wasn't going with him. I was going with the other two guys. And they put me in the car, and I remember driving and just being like, oh, I'll try to keep it light and just talk to these guys, you know what I mean? I'll just
You're
talk to
a goddamn criminal.
They know that I'm there for a seatbelt, an unpaid seatbelt ticket. They told me
You're
that.
Like, I hate the Eagles, man.
How great would it be if, while you're in the back, they just change it? Like, yeah, well, that little girl didn't have to die.
What?
Yeah, we got you.
Well, actually, funny how they got me was more this. They go, I've never been in jail in New York before, so I didn't know, like, the terms and their local fucking horseshit here. I also didn't watch enough SVU at the time. Mm-hmm. I've become a fan since.
Okay.
I would have known what they meant here. But they were laughing, and I go, hey, guys, I was like, can you be... I mean, I gave me, like, a broomstick up the butt, like, joke, which probably, in hindsight, was bad taste. And
since you're heading to a place where that's a...
It's probably in bad taste.
Yeah, possibility. Yeah. And they go, oh, he goes, you're hilarious, man. He goes, they're going to love you down in the tombs. And just the word the tombs was so, like, you're like, oh, yeah. What does that mean?
Butthole type.
And they go, oh, you'll see. You'll see soon enough. But they, actually, first thing they did, it happened in Midtown, like, in the 50s. They drove me, they took me to a precinct in the 70s first. I sat in there with a guy named Hector who kept just yelling he was innocent in his cell. It was two cells, and I was in one, he was in the other for some reason. Kept saying he was innocent, and then I'm, again, making jokes. I'm like, yeah, me too. And I was even kind of doing, like, the nobody knows the trouble. I was like, doing, like, the, you know, like, rubbing, like, the cup. I guess I was rubbing the cup against the bar, and, like, the guy just wouldn't break. The guy was filling out paperwork, and he wouldn't break, and he was kind of shitty. Then they took me again, and they brought me in the back of a car, cuffed me again, brought me in the back of a car, took me up to Harlem.
Okay. Way gay.
Harlem, they chain-ganged me. They chained me to some much more unsavory characters than my friend Hector. Hector ended up being an all right dude.
Yeah, by comparison.
I was...
Hector's grandfather.
The guy who I was to, I was first or last, depending on how he walked, in the chain gang line.
Yeah.
You're all chained by your wrists.
Oh, boy.
With this guy who, he was dressed like, well, it was like a Wu-Tang wedding outfit, sort of. It was like a sweater vest with nothing underneath it.
Yes.
Wow.
We call that's like a mid-90s LL Cool J. It can also be...
This was...
DMX?
This was the early aughts we're talking here.
This is a DMX version.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Skinny, tall, skinny guy. And he was wearing dress pants and dress shoes, but he was, like, bleeding in different parts of his, like, arm and stuff like that. And face. And he had this big, like, Wishnik troll hair. And I was next to him, and they put us all next to each other, and he just seemed like he was in a way worse mood than I was, even. And then they load us all into, like, this bread truck, sort of thing. Like, it's a police thing, but it was police, but it was like, how, you know, like a U-Haul.
We got to put you guys on the milk route.
I'm not exaggerating. They put us in
into the East River.
Maybe there was vents in the sides, but it was like a ventless U-Haul, I would say, almost.
It's a big square.
It's a big square, yeah. And they have like a short bench on each side of it. There was four sets of five of us chain gang together. So two sets sat, and I was in the part that stood and held on to this like little bar. Hot. Summertime. Really, really hot. And now, every day, I cry one tear.
That's the sound getting on the train.
But they, and I'm on the thing, and all I'm hearing people, like, they're starting, and everyone's getting ornery, man, because it's, like, hot in this thing. And people are looking to fight. We can't see a thing. It's pitch black.
What?
And they're just driving down, like, Park Avenue, is how they took down. I know that because it's the way we came up, and it was like, it's all over the place, you know, the car, this thing's getting thrown all over the place, and people are bumping into each other, and literally getting into, like, shoving matches.
No.
And all I feel is I'm holding this thing, I don't want to fall.
Yeah.
My other arm's chained to a guy, so it's got to stay low. And I feel
how
sweat.
Tired was your arm?
Man.
I wasn't even thinking about that. I just know there was sweat coming down my arm, and I was like, I'm going to start sweating on the people sitting.
Shit.
And I'm like, and that's going to be a fight. I don't want to be in a fight in this close. I was terrified of this situation.
Yeah, that's the last place
I'm like,
get
come on,
fight.
Man. So I'm just like trying to, like, every time they'd stop at a light, like trying to, like, you know, like wipe my arm on my own, like, side of my body and then go back up and hold the thing. Awful.
Jesus.
Take us down to 100 Center Street. The guy who I'm chained to, Wishnick Trollhair, is being just less than cooperative, we'll say, with everybody. He's calling the black cops Uncle Toms and all this shit. He's going haywire at these guys. He's trying to fight people and everything like that. So,
and you're chained to him.
Chained to him. They finally let us go. They put us all into the cells.
Yeah.
Take our pictures. They do the whole thing. I'm in the cell with this guy, and now I'm just sitting there trying to, like, be small in a corner, mind my business, whatever. Wishnick Trollhair guy comes over, and he keeps asking me what time it is. Kept asking me what time it is, and I'm telling him the time. But he's doing it like, I mean, every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes. At this point, it's probably like 1 in the morning, 2 in the morning.
I was just doing him.
Oh, yeah. 1 in the morning, Dan. No, it was like 1
what
in the morning.
What time is it?
And I keep telling him, and then finally he asked at a point. And again, I wasn't physically intimidated by this guy.
You were, yeah.
I was physically intimidated by the situation because I'm like, this guy's probably got more friends in here than I have. You know what I mean?
Sure.
Like, I don't want to be in a fist fight in here.
Can I?
You know what I mean? Like, it's not like a fist fight where you get pulled and we're going to be somewhere else. Yeah.
Were you in a cell alone? Or were you actually
with
him?
No, there was a whole... We're in the tombs now, what they're talking about. Also in the tombs, they give you back all of your shit they took at first.
What?
Shoelaces, belts, everything. And I'm like, I don't want them back.
Yeah.
Because when I'm asking why are you taking them, they're saying weapons, choking, trying to kill yourself, all these things. And I'm like... Okay, and then they're giving it all back. Keys, I'm telling you everything. And I was like...
And you're just like 11 weapons. He's like a fucking...
I'm almost going, I don't want it back. Like, I didn't want it back.
So like, I stubbed my toe on your boot, and it hurts like a motherfucker.
I don't need weapons.
Yeah, I do this with my hands.
So you're in the tombs.
I just imagine you sitting Indian style in the middle of the jail cell now.
Someone told me a story about that happening once. Like a little, like little tiny Asian guy who just sat Indian style, like kicked one guy in the throat who was giving him shit eventually, and then went back to sitting like that, and no one bothered him again the rest of the time. But I wasn't there.
That's awesome.
And so the guy kept asking me for the time, and finally I was like, hey, man. I go, I'll tell you the time, dude. I go, but you're... I mean, the guy said we're going to be here till tomorrow. He already told us that. Like... Stop asking me. I'll tell you the time. Just like, you know, give me an hour.
Yeah.
He's like, yeah, man, you're right, man. My bad. He goes, just give me the watch. And I was like, and then it wasn't even a backpedal, but I was like, look, dude, you asked me the time. Just, you know, I'm not giving my watch, but you can ask me the time. I didn't even get, I've already dialed back from the hour. Like, I didn't think
it's enough.
I'm not saying ask whenever you want, but traffic I'm definitely doing like the, hey, man, you know, just ask a little less. It's cool. I'll hold the watch.
What
it's
fine.
You don't want the burden to hold the watch. People are going to be asking you for the time. You're going to be going through all that.
I'll play Big Ben.
I'm going to tell you this right now. It's a knockoff. It's not real.
Guy took a wild swipe at me, somehow missed.
What?
And then I just kind of grabbed his face, and we were just fucking grabbing each other, like both of us kind of going for each other's throats, and I just was like, yelling the word officer, and the cop came over and like literally just raps the bars with his stick, and he's like, hey, knock it off, and he stops. Then I was laying there, sitting there, and he just was like staring at me.
Fuck.
For the next hour. Sobbing uncontrollably.
Fuck. For the next hour, he's sitting there, and I'm just kind of sitting there keeping like a hard face on myself, but inside just going like, all I'm saying is don't fall asleep. Don't fall asleep. And then I fell asleep. Woke up to this guy's hand on my throat.
Come on.
And, yeah. And then it just made me like, just like swinging at him. We're just kind of grabbing and pushing, and the cop came over again and broke us up. He ended up getting moved to a different cell, but we're still, it's a cell, dude. I'm telling you, there's 30 people in these cells, each one. At one point, I guess from people moving around enough, they were condensing cells.
Oh, shit.
And I was just the last one to stand up from the last one. I was the last person to get up. Everyone's kind of out of the cell, and the guy goes, you want to come over? The cop. And I was like, wait. I'm like, I don't have to go over there. He's like, I don't care. I was like, you can stay in here if you want. And you just look over at, like, now probably about 40, 50 people in that cell.
Yeah.
And you just say to yourself, if I'm going to be with them again at some point.
Right.
If I'm clearly that guy who stayed back this one time, like, that's going to probably worse. So let me just go in. And I went into the thing. That cell ended up being, like, me and that guy never had a thing. I don't even remember he was in the cell anymore. But I remember getting to hear such great conversations, like, just like, literally, like the movie South Central, like an older black guy with a long beard, like wearing one of those, like, you know, knitted, like, goofy hats, was just sitting there telling stories. He was like, everything's weird. He goes, let me tell you, brother, something. You cut off the head, the body died. That's what happened to the mafia. He goes, John Gotti got killed. Whole mafia fall apart. Cut off the head, the body died. Someone goes, what'd you do? He goes, I whooped up on my stepdaughter. Had nothing to do with anything that he was talking about.
That's hilarious. Do you understand?
I always forget, because I told the story so much when I was like younger. When it happened, I forgot that he also said that John Gotti died from aneurysm cancer, which is one of my favorite things I've ever heard in my life.
This guy knows what he's talking
about. Aneurysm cancer is my favorite.
Here's what happens. You get an aneurysm, but you okay.
Aneurysm
cancer. That aneurysm starts smoking.
Yeah. If you hurt a man,
maybe
he will eventually, his wounds will heal.
Maybe that aneurysm was working around a lot of asbestos.
His aneurysm had the cancer.
Don't you understand that mesothelioma, or as I call it, the white man's grip on society. What you in here for?
Pocket tickets.
I whooped on my stepdaughter.
Stole a Twix.
My stepdaughter came home late. I yelled at him.
So, yeah. He has like Les Miserables crimes.
Yeah.
I stole bread from my family.
Diamonds to feed my family.
Insider trading tips.
But my last fight was over those frozen sandwiches. Crazy. That's what it was. It was over those like frozen sandwiches. A guy asked me for my sandwich. Actually, I'd given it to. I gave my first. They're frozen. They're completely frozen, by the way, straight through. They're inedible. Bologna sandwich on bread. It's the ones they're giving us were frozen in a little thing of chocolate milk.
Okay.
Did you kept the milk? I drank the chocolate milk.
It's delicious.
And a guy asked me if he could have my.
Was it like Super Cow, like elementary school milk?
Yeah. Yeah. Nice. The boxes. Okay. The guy asked me if he could have my sandwich if I was needing it. And I went, yeah, sure, and I handed it to him, and he was like, and he took it from me, and he goes, bitch-ass motherfucker. This was way early in the night, so I'm sorry to jump back, but I forgot about that. He called me a bitch-ass motherfucker, and I was like, all right, I was like, oh, like, I guess I get it, like, that's like the, we're deciding the hierarchy, I guess, of this stupid, by the way, I was in there for 20 hours. That's it. I mean, like I said, it's a long time, but like,
that's a
for
long
all these
hours.
Things that happen in 20 hours, yeah. So later, I'm in the last cell before I go to see the judge. I've talked to the public defender already, and I'm sitting there. I'm feeling less bad now. There's a Mexican guy in there sharpening his keys on the wall.
Oh,
weird. They give us the sandwiches again, and the guy says to me...
With the keys?
No. They give me a sandwich, not keys guy. Keys guy was just smiling at me, which I thought was weird, while he was sharpening keys. I don't know if he was saying, like, check this out, or, like, you're next. But they give us the sandwiches, and I'm just not eating mine again. And some guy goes, hey, man, he goes, let me get that sandwich. And so I didn't want it, so I literally just say to him, I go, yeah, dude, listen, you could have the sandwich because I don't want it. I'm not eating it, so you could have it. I go, if I wanted it, though.
I'm absolutely not a bitch-ass motherfucker.
No, I didn't even say that. I just go, I go, if I wanted it, though, I wouldn't give it to you, just so you know that. But I'll give it to you. I don't care. And he goes, I ain't eating it either, man. I'm going to use that shit as a pillow. And then I said, I go, well, dude, then I'm not going to, because there's like, there's homeless guys. There's people in there that no one's bothering because they're just like gross homeless people. Yeah. I go, I'm just going to give it to one of those guys. And he goes, man, give me the sandwich. And he like pushed my face. And then me and him had a weird, that was literally like, I just threw a wild shot and like hit him. Like in the neck or like, yeah. And just like look, I just hit him and looked for the cop because that was much closer quarters, and I was like, the cops were kind of right there.
How close quarters?
The size of this room they're in right now. So I don't know what is
fucking
this
fucking A, man.
Fucking 20 by 30 or something, maybe. Not even 20. It's like 20.
Hardened.
Jesus, yeah, Lord. No, but I'm telling you, when I went to that judge, and he basically goes, you know, like, it's like $80 fine and time served. Like, you thought I beat murder the way I was. I mean, I cheered. Yeah. I started shaking hands. I walked out there so happy. Dude, it was the worst. It was horrible. Horrible, horrible situation. But, I mean, a killer story, I guess.
Jesus,
but, I mean, like,
fucking Christ.
If that ever happens again, call me again, and I'll answer with my phone going, yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'll be, I don't know. I mean,
it's like
poor people lose.
Well, Jay, were you driving or not?
Poor people lose. You never spent the night in jail ever?
No.
You have such white face. Thank you.